What's up? What's up? Super, super excited because today it's all about video. What I'm going to be sharing are some pretty jaw-dropping stats that I've recently discovered through listening to some training by Maury Smith, who is a Facebook expert, actually even hired on by Facebook. I'm also going to be sharing some elements of an effective video and just giving you some tips in general. So the first thing is, did you know that 40% of video views come from shares? It's super, super important now to start creating content that is shareable. You want to think, entertain, educate, inspire, okay? And so here is a big tip that I'm going to give you when it comes to getting people like to share your content. First and foremost, as soon as you start your videos, immediately jump into the content. Like, you want to capture people's attention right off the bat, because most views, again, they come from video shares, but most people who are watching your video are not going to be live, okay? So they're going to be replay viewers. And as a matter of fact, I heard this statistic a while back, and that is the fact that you have about 8 seconds to capture somebody's attention before they decide whether or not they're going to watch you or move on to the next person. So if you are someone and you're sitting here and you're like, oh, well, I'm just gonna wait, like, let me know that you popped on, you're gonna lose people and they're gonna move on to watch somebody else. So that is a huge tip. Get straight into your content. Here are a couple of other pretty cool stats. 90% of information transmitted to the brain is visual. Visuals are processed 60,000 times faster in the brain than text. Here is a super cool stat. Enjoyment of video ads increases purchase intent by 97%, okay? And brand association by 139%. This is another stat from Maury Smith. People are 67% more likely to watch a square video to completion than they are to watch a horizontal one. So square videos actually perform better than portrait videos on Facebook and Instagram. I did hear from Maury Smith that there is an app called the Wave app. Now, although it's an app, it's not for mobile. You can only do this on a desktop. And you can find out more information about Wave by going to animatron.com/wave. And that is animatron.com/wave. They have a free version. They also have a few different paid options. So here are some elements of an effective video. Number one, capture people's attention right away. Again, like I stated earlier, don't tell people that you're going to wait to get into the content. You want to get into the content immediately. You want to create videos that are going to evoke emotion. They're going to be personal, relatable. Like, you want to be relatable, because if somebody doesn't feel like they can relate to you, your content, what you're talking about, you're never going to be able to grow a business. Because people do business with people they know, like, and trust. They do business with people they relate to, okay? Here's another tip. When you are going live, you want to create a compelling title that's going to grab people's attention and get them to want to click on your video, to want to watch it. And all too often, again, when I am looking at people's videos, I look, and even if they're doing video, they have no title. There's no description, no title. And here's the deal. If you're creating a video and you don't have a title, like, why would I hop on your video, right? Here are some other tips. You want to begin with the end in mind. So what's the purpose of your video? What's your call to action going to be? Now, a call to action is basically where you're giving people a reason to dive deeper. Like, you're giving them the next step that you want them to take. So before you go live, you need to think about, okay, what's the purpose of my video? What's my call to action gonna be? Like, what's the end result, okay? And you want to make sure that it's congruent with what you're talking about. So if you're sitting here and you are giving, like, tips on how to fight the signs of aging, and then your call to action is, hey, if you want to know how to, you know, get rid of acne, well, that's not congruent and it doesn't make sense. So you always want to make sure that your call to action is congruent with your topic and what you're talking about. And also remember, like, who is your video for? Like, who's your audience? You sometimes feel that you want to please everybody, right? So you're scared to run anybody off because you want to be the go-to for everybody. And that's the thing, like, don't be afraid to turn people off. Know who your audience is. Know who you are talking to. Because when you have a clear understanding of who your target audience is, that's how you're going to get people to feel that emotion and feel like, oh my gosh, like, dude, she's talking to me. Like, I totally felt like everything she was talking about was, like, for me, okay? That's how you build know, like, and trust, okay? Know your target audience. Don't be afraid to turn people off. So, these are just some new stats. And remember, things change. You know, what used to be, like, what you used to should do, you know, 3 months ago, 6 months ago, isn't necessarily what's performing best now, which is why it's always very important to stay up to date on what's working now. Now, here is a quote by Mark Zuckerberg himself when it comes to video and the direction that Facebook is headed, okay? Video will be a much bigger driver of what we'll do over the next 2 to 3 years versus Messenger and WhatsApp, okay? So they, again, Mark Zuckerberg has said this a trillion times, and he said it again, that video is going to be a main driver of Facebook over the next 2 to 3 years. And they're even going to be Facebook TV, like, Facebook TV is coming, okay? If you haven't already noticed, there is also a dedicated video newsfeed where it's just videos. So if you are not creating videos, you need to hop on this train. You need to get over your fear and you need to do it. You need to realize that, hey, if you're not, you know, currently doing videos and you're a little scared, like, hey, you might suck in the beginning. I was totally horrible in the beginning when I started doing videos, but just like riding your bike, just like when you're, you know, teaching your little baby how to walk, you're gonna fall down, you're gonna suck in the beginning, but if you keep doing it, you're gonna get better and better and better, and before you know it, you're gonna be like all natural, you know what I mean? It's so much easier for me now to go live than it is to do a pre-recorded video. And know that when it comes to videos, you are able to build rapport with people so much quicker than if you're just putting up, like, blog posts or you're sharing just a picture, because people get a sense of who you are. They get a sense of, like, what you're about, your personality, and that allows you to build rapport with a large amount of people much, much faster, okay? So hope you have an amazing day, and until next time.